This is a short tutorial about the really amazing service from Google called Google Hangouts. It's absolutely free and lets you hold online meetings with a few people and full presentations with an unlimited number of people. It's like a Skype call with easy screen sharing, so you can show people a webcam image of your face, PowerPoint presentations, or just about anything else that you can show on your computer. You can have up to 10 presenters, an unlimited number of viewers in your audience, and your presentations can easily be recorded for viewing or later sharing. For requirements, you'll need a microphone that you hook up to your computer if you don't already have one. You can also use a webcam to show your face during presentations, but it's not required. You will need a Google account, which is free, and you'll need to activate a Google Plus account, which is really easy. I'll show you in just a few minutes how to do that. Google Hangouts has two different services. First is Google Hangouts itself, where you can meet online with up to 10 friends or coworkers or collaborators for an online meeting. Number two is Google Hangouts On Air. It's almost the same as Google Hangouts, but it records the presentation for up to 4 hours, so you can have up to 10 presenters like Google Hangouts, but also you can have an unlimited number of viewers with live streaming. Now, presenter requirements are all presenters need a Google Plus account. But if someone doesn't have a Google Plus account, you can phone them and get them into the meeting that way as well. For Google Hangouts On Air, where you're doing a presentation to many visitors, the main presenter needs a YouTube account because the video that's created needs to be stored somewhere, and that's where it gets stored. Your audience doesn't need any of that. All they need is an internet connection, and they can watch and listen to the entire presentation online. That YouTube account needs to unlock the account's 15-minute barrier. When you set up a YouTube account, they set a limit of 15 minutes for videos that play. To unlock it, go to the settings area of your YouTube account. It says, "Want to upload videos longer than 15 minutes? Click here." Then simply follow their directions and you'll be able to record your full presentation for up to 4 hours. Now, Google Hangouts On Air can record your full presentation, which is really great. It does a live stream with about a 20-second delay for your audience. But the live stream is public as you're doing the presentation, but once the video is created, you can make it private, or you can download it or edit it as you like. For the presenters, you can have up to 10 hosts or participants, each with the ability to share their screen or simply have a webcam view of them like Skype if you've ever used a Skype call. When presenting, Google Hangouts is seen just by the people in your meeting. But for Google Hangouts On Air, your audience can see the full presentation on your YouTube channel, on your Google Plus page, or you can embed the presentation window on any page of your website, the same way you embed a YouTube video on your website. The main apps for Google Hangouts On Air are Screen Share, Invite People, where you can add presenters to your call, Chat, where your audience can post questions and comments in a chat box, and Effects, with sound effects like audience clapping and other fun stuff. And there's one more important app, the Cameraman app. It lets you decide who gets seen by everyone and who gets heard or muted. And what gets seen by your audience? The webcam view lets your audience see who's talking if you have a webcam on your computer. You can also show static programs like Word and PowerPoint. I'm not sure you'd want to show a video because you'd be showing a stream of a stream and that could get pretty choppy. To set up, if you don't have a Google Plus account, go to Google and type Google Plus with a plus sign. That'll take you to the Google Plus sign-in page. At the Google sign-in, if you have any Google account, a Gmail, YouTube, or any other Google account, simply use the password and sign in. If you don't have a Google account, click the Create Account button and follow the instructions. Now, once you have a Google Plus account, to open a Google Hangout session where you have an online meeting with up to 10 people, get into your account. On the top right, click the green comma thing that says Hangouts. It'll open the plus new Hangout box. When you click the box, start typing who you're inviting. As soon as you start typing, it'll show the names of Google Plus members. Check the box for who you want in the meeting. When you're ready to begin your meeting, click the camera to start your Hangout. You'll hear a phone dialing as it attempts to contact your invited people. If they're logged into Google Plus, a pop-up alerts them to join the meeting. Once the meeting starts, a window opens with a control panel. Click the phone hang-up button when your meeting is finished. To start a Hangouts On Air presentation where you present to an unlimited audience, in Google Plus, hover over the Home button. This menu pops up. Click Hangouts On Air. It takes you to this page, which is plus.google.com/hangouts. Click the blue button, Start Hangouts On Air, and it opens Google Hangouts On Air. So here's a sample of the Google Hangouts On Air screen, which is almost exactly the same as the Google Hangouts screen, except it has just a few more controls. So on the top left, you've got a click this button here and you can expand out the controls. And the first one is invite people. Click on this and it lets you invite people. A little screen opens up. As you go down here, click this and you've got screen share, and it allows you to click on any one of these screens and then you can share a different image with the people that you have on the call. Then you go down here, you have your cameraman setting where you click on this and it gives you control over what people can see on the call itself. You want to make sure that the default is changed here. It says broadcast the large video that I see to my audience, blah, 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 blah. What this basically means is, do you want to be in control of what people see or not? You want to say yes on this, which is a second button up from the bottom. And that allows you to be in control. If you're not in control, then whoever's speaking, the camera will shift to that person. But it's much better for you as from a control standpoint than you can actually control what people see. The bottom button here is Google Effects. You click on this and it actually gives you fun effects like audience applause and some other ones. Across the top, you've got a button that says, you've got a link that says embed. If you click on this here, it opens up the link and you just copy this and you paste it on whatever your web page that you want to show the presentation on, and it will embed just like it does embeds a video on your page. And then when you're ready, you just click here to start broadcast, and then you click here again to end broadcast. And that's it. Hopefully this was helpful. If you do presentations, Google Hangouts is an awesome tool, and the best part is it's free. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. And if you're a coach, a consultant, or a marketer, visit our website for more tips and tools at marketingfortopcoaches.com.